but he wants his Twitch chat karma. This man right here.
It's the baby rage.
The ugliest anti-mage set I've seen in a while. Where's the burning set, my friend? Not doing it for me, Arteezy.
Yeah, burning.
What's this weird, like, mohawk?
Burning's got the coolest anti-mage set. I like that.
Yeah, you were also flaming the Golden Bashers, though, so I have to question your taste. They're supposed to be gaudy. They're supposed to be over the top. They make people stop and look. It's like you're blaning out your anti-mage, man. You're not a fan.
If I had them, I'd probably just use them because, like you say, they're kind of gaudy. But from a pure aesthetics point of view, I don't know.
You're not feeling it.
Not feeling it.
All right.
With that said, the Casper Nick set, I think, is the most badass thing ever. So
let's go. MVP. They could maybe look for a first blood here. Zai a bit too far away.
Didn't have the ward.
Didn't place the ward, though.
Yeah.
He may fake them out. They may assume there's one planted down. And there are everybody penny mid, apparently.
Yeah. What's the communication? Someone's like, go block the mid lane for me, or whatever it may be.
You go here. No, you go there. Okay, I'm going here. We all move together. Let's five-man the rune. Sounds good.
Yeah. By the way, it is S4 gyrocopter, so it looks like we will see a mid gyrocopter. We'll have to see if this is going to be like some
homing missile max. Here we go.
I think at least one point will be coming out, whether it's going to be max. I think max homing missiles,
it's fun. It's not very good, generally.
It's so annoying to deal with in lane for any hero, and it gives you roaming potential, but it's just like, it's on instant initiation. It's very kind of, you can see it coming, and then you just TP in heroes, and you can respond to it, so.
It is going to be the mid-jug. This is something I love to do in pubs, but I got to tell you, he's not a very strong mid, generally.
You see the homing missile, you see the rocket barrage, you Blade Fury. You're good.
He's not going to die, most likely, but he's going to have trouble getting his farm QO, Will.
Yeah.
If you get in too close to these creeps, S4 will start to give you the rocket barrage.
He's got the poor man's shield, so as soon as he sees S4 flacking, he's like, oh, I'm just going to run up and start right-clicking you.
Bear in mind, Blade Fury has a really long cooldown at the early levels, 42 seconds, and it's mana intensive as well, and not rushing the bottle here. So QO's going to have to play defense, farm under the tower. Be defensive about this.
Nuts is going for the mid pull, it looks like. That PPD was doing yesterday in the EG game.
That's what MVP are up to, we were wondering. We're going to get our answers. Does he get it right here?
Yeah, I'm not sure if he's missed it once already or if this is going to be his first attempt.
You want to shards them in when they get close enough, right when that... Oh, there's the shards, and... No, I don't think he got it.
It was a little, slightly missed time.
Uh-oh. That if your whole game plan hinges on that, and that's not working, what's the plan B? He doesn't have Snowball. It's only level 1. He may just have to go Leech top with Marsh.
Yeah, it feels very much like something they kind of learned overnight and maybe haven't fine-tuned yet because...
Maybe did it once or twice in a practice lobby, but...
Yeah.
Because it's the pressure of a real game. That's a bit different. But they do bring Nuts in at a good time here, trying to go in Kuro. Oh, the Ice Shards trapping him in, along with the tree line, where March and Kuro are fighting it out right now, but they can't really keep up with him quite. Another Ice Shards in 10. They may engage with the double Ion Shell. Who do they chase onto? Nuts dropping low here. The lead is done. No, MVP gonna give up the first button. March may well be the secondary kill, as Arteezy toys with him. He doesn't have a blink, though. He's just a bit too fast with the South. Gets out of range, and more stuns are coming out. Now March is gonna give up a secondary kill. Surge, not enough. Two freebies. As in the mid lane, QO is going to turn on S4. But as you can see, Blade Fury now down for a long time, and already Rocket Barrage is back up. It's cute, but it's not really a full counter.
Secret just never panic, like in those moments where a lot of teams in that kind of 2v3 scenario, they've got an Iron Shell, Tusk, and Daxia running at them, would not coordinate their just... They'd stun stack the Frostbite with the LSAs. The anti-mage would be like, oh, I don't want to go in back in. I'm too low HP. It's too risky to blink in aggressively on an Iron Shell hero. Just no panic whatsoever. They use their spells, maximize their efficiency, and yeah, they punish the aggression for MVP. Nice play.
And they get double boots on the supports now as well.
I think they saw, they've seen the Tusky from the high ground. This is going to be really bad for Nuts. He can get cut off as well by the gyrocopter.
He does have a snowball at the very least to try and dodge some damage, and he's just going to roll to the creep wave. Well, gank's over, folks, and I guess he may try the mid pull again. Let's see what Nuts wants to do now, but this laning stage is already a disaster as far as that goes. So how are the other lanes doing? Well, Klinks is farming well bottom lane.
CS-wise, yeah.
Jug's doing okay.
Jug's winning by a little bit. Winning by 4 last hits. He's a few more denies on the gyrocopter side, but
does have his bottle.
Jug's doing fine.
Yeah. That's something. It's just the other three heroes that we worry about right now. The Naga is getting some levels bottom, but
yeah.
Dual lane, off lane, not really cutting it, and Arteezy, with the start he's had, should be able to just free farm top.
Yeah, I don't feel like they can. They can't send the Tusk alone up here expecting to help March. No Surgeon. He's going to get jumped on now. Surgeon one, but he's frostbitten, and Arteezy takes that last hit. No support text today. But
while that was happening, they found a kill on S4. They just try again, and they had the lane war top. So they knew that Kuro and Puppy were busy on the gank, and VP, not deterred by the easy double kill they gave up early, are going to bounce right back, get something going mid, and good news about Jug mid, and the cool thing about it, is that you do get really fast levels on the hero, who scales, all of his spells scale really well. The Blade Fury, the Healing Ward's great at level 1, but also scales pretty nicely, and even Blade Dance, something you want to get some points in, so it is a nice trade-off here running him mid, and with a quick Omni Slash and an Invis rune, might be able to go for a kill.
Let's say, looks like he might turn around, picks up boots. Tusk is there with a snowball. He has to wait for the Blade Fury cooldown, but that's 10 seconds away. Oh,
they brought in Febby, but he's been scouted. There's a dire ward here.
Still Invis rune. He'll see that QO doesn't. His QO, I'm about to say, QO's probably just going to pop up, because if you don't go for the last hit on that Siege Creep, it's like, well, why is now Jug here? He had an Invis rune. I'm guessing he's an Invis.
Even if it's just the Jug, though, he can easily get a kill on S4 solo, but here comes the backup snowball coming in. S4 getting punished again. There's the Rocket Barrage because QO's Blade Fury, and only Nuts tanks it. Causes him to drop very low. Puppy looking for the counter gank, and they may lose Nuts. Can he share a bottle charge with his buddy? Oh, he could have bottled Nuts up and kept him alive, but instead QO says, I'm sacrificing you for the greater good, my friend. I want the kill.
It didn't look like CM was going to get two right clicks off there, but just barely managed to get that last one after leaving him on 5 HP. And
do you like getting the kill there, or would you have liked to see him save the Tusk better?
I think he made the right play. Like, I actually thought that the Tusk was going to live, because that one right click from the CM coming out wasn't going to kill him, but somehow Puppy just got close enough for another. So I think it was the right play, because there was a chance that the Tusk was going to live too.
Okay. Wow.
And Tusk, he says he's not bitter. He TP's back mid, refills QO's bottle for him as he TP's in, so no hard feelings.
They are farming KP as well, up to 32 CS, keeping up with Arteezy in that department. Down about 400 because of the hero kills. He does have Death Pact online. This is where you can get away with a greedier draft, rotate the Clinks into the jungle, and look to get the rest of your team space. QO, phase boots coming out soon on the courier. The phase boots, they may be able to... He may be able to threaten S4 with a solo kill. Rushing for the top rune, he doesn't have a Blade Fury for 5 seconds. There's the call down Rocket Barrage as well. He's going to be forced back. And S4 will secure what is only a Bounty Rune. Doesn't have his bottle.
Yeah, now he just bottle crows, and S4 is really mana starved now, which is a bit of a problem for him. He needs mana to be able to fight QO here, just the one Rocket Barrage.
And he can't punish this.
Oh, there's also a rune at bottom, so he just goes and grabs his DD now.
That's unfortunate. You drop that cooldown, you really want the big rune. Meanwhile, top lane, watching March on the run. Mana Void there, not quite enough for Arteezy. Blinkit 7, Salve, insta-canceled, but they force out the TP, and that will allow March to survive. MVP doing amazingly well. Let's remember how this laning stage started. Oh. They ran the Tusk. Oh, they're trying to make it go on mid here.
Yeah.
They do have Omni Slash in soon, not quite yet. They're going to make their go here on S4 right now. Clink Searing Arrow's coming out. He's trying to tank the tower, but it's a lot of damage. Now wants to go with the Blade Fury. He doesn't have the phase boots move speed. Oh, QO can't quite get the job done. Now Kuro looking for the exchange. He hits the stun and the LSA. Febby's there to disengage. One more auto attack would do it. QO, he's going to phase and deny to Ancients. Well, let's hope he's not too tanky to die before the secret supports come in, and he's not. He will fall, but I mean, gods. It started with the failed Ice Shards pull. They ran top. They gave up a double and a first blood.
Tusk.
And then the game has just been MVP swinging it right back their way.
Well, Tusk died at the bottom lane there to a clockwork, it looks like. And this is where they want to get the Klinks active on the map. This is a good way to play the Klinks. He's hit level 7, has 3 points in Searing Arrows, couple in the Skeleton Walk, and gets a ton of damage whenever he Death Packs a big creep. So he's just going to keep looking for these kills, and like another TP back towards the mid lane. They may have another go on S4.
They have a Hill Ward. I don't know Kuro's if he saw KP, though. He's
Kuro's in
Viz.
In a bad spot, too.
Oh, what's the rune? Ah, just a regen. Now Kuro knows KP's in the neighborhood, but he's just going to go straight onto him. Dodges the stun. Don't know if he has enough damage. Needs one more auto attack. The long range shards. Clip him. Gives the vision.
Oh,
no!
Two?
The uphill miss. Don't tell me. Oh, Kuro! Living a charmed life! Second time today where Kuro's just had the RNG gods on his side. That's not fair. That's just not fair.
You should get like double the evasion chance because he shot that second arrow up two cliffs. It was like the one stairs and then the second stairs. So
okay. Maybe if that were how it worked, then I would agree. Then that's how the mechanic worked, then that's fair.
But double miss, Kuro, man. Sometimes you just gotta be a bit lucky, and
he's been getting pretty lucky. The bash up the hill that just helps him retreat earlier, and now that. Meanwhile, Arteezy is starting to take a bit more pressure though. March dropping the wall and getting active in this top lane. Been forced to go for the extra regen here. Gets the early reign of regen, likely to go into the Vlad's build. It's a small adjustment you can do as an anti-mage, where generally you want to rush the Battle Fury, but the extra plus HP regen does make a difference here. Pesky Ion Shell.
Now, Febby at bottom lane. He's kind of been left down bottom by himself, as Klinks wants to roam, Jug wants to keep fighting, but as a result, he's just being punished time and time again.
Oh, March is diving Arteezy. He's holding the blink right now. He's looking for the Monovoid kill. He's going to have to blink out soon. Arteezy very patient on this one. He's turning. Now he blinks, but KP cuts off the retreat as they snowball in onto Zai through the cogs and directly on top. Then they trap him on the other side, but he hooks away. Zai, the secret escape plan was routed, and he will make it out. Looking for the QO dive mid in the meanwhile with the call down. They're still trying to hunt Zai a little bit, but he should escape. Not so lucky mid as S4. Omni was thrown out. Blade Fury there as well. Can't run from the Juggernaut. Solo mid, Jug on a killing spree. And what looked like kind of a pub strat from MVP coming together as they pull ahead in terms of gold and experience, almost back to even.
Yeah, they're just, everything seems to be kind of going their way with their two roaming carries, Jug and Klinks both getting a lot done. Klinks now up to a couple of kills and assists. Juggernaut's been involved in multiple kills on S4. S4 is just seeing mid 0 and 3, and this mid Gyrocopter has not really amounted to much whatsoever this game.
And he's just going defensive now. Even gets the power treads. No phase boots for S4 with the amount of pressure QO's put on him. It shows the power of Tusk, I think, more than anything, that he had the tough start, dies top, fails the mid pull, and then just comes in mid and sets up kills anyway. And he's going in again onto S4, cleaved to pieces by the Blade Dance, just chops him in half and serves him up for dinner. And all the while, they're giving Febby some space bottom. This is what you love about the Klinks as a carry, and I think one of the big reasons why EG like to run it just lets you leave a lane very early. Not only do you pressure, but you give something to your supports.
Yeah, and you kind of get farm at the same time when you're taking jungle creeps as well, the Death Pact. Unfortunately, he's going to get caught out by Clockwork, and
he's got charges, no backup. But not going
to
matter.
Healing Ward tries to come in, but Puppy snipes it, so. Nice play from Zai, just being in the right position and knowing that the Klinks was about to move into the jungle because his Death Pact wore off. So not only do you know where he's going to be, but he's going to be squishy because he doesn't have that bonus HP.
Oh, again with the Midases. Secret. This is three games in a row where we've seen a Puppy Midas.
And the other important thing is Puppy spent a lot of time jungling, and jungle CM kind of hurts Klinks because you don't have any big... Like, Klinks went into the jungle, found the big camp of Secret, and there were no big creeps. There was like seven little leftovers from Puppy CM. All the little, like, baby centaurs and little baby trolls, whatever they are, that don't actually give you much HP or damage. So that actually really worked against the Klinks, that Puppy had just left all these little useless creeps for him to death pact, or he didn't even bother death pacting them.
Very back and forth game. Bit of a slugfest here for the team. Zai, the one who's making a lot of moves around the map, is they are going to rotate S4 back into the jungle. He'll start farming some stacks, leaving the bottom lane abandoned for now. That does give Febby additional free farm. Curious to see when he gets active and what
they're
able to accomplish.
I think Febby's just going to go into the Radiance knock at this point.
Really?
It feels that way. It feels like they're going to play QO more just like a constant ganker, get like a drums. Maybe a Shadow Blade or an Acceptor. Go
looking for QO. Can he Blade Fury in time? He gets caught back. He will Blade Fury. Pops the Drum Charge, rotates out, and they snowball in with the Ice Shards. They've got a Walrus Punch here. Uppercut onto Zai, but he's tanky, and they can't get in. The Ice Shards actually working against QO now. Song to reset. To Secret want to bring anyone in. Omni, Kuro down. They want Zai, though. This is the big kill. He hooks away again. This guy is a trapeze artist with that friggin' hook, and he will retreat. March, meanwhile, dropping the wall. He's fighting against three, but it's a really nice one. Gonna kill off Puppy with it. Gets the experience first. Well worth it as they'll take the tower mid. MVP. They are just keeping up with Secret. I love the intensity of this team. Endless action. Never afraid to take a fight. And It seems that's how you get to Secret, who just want to play the slow, methodical game versus most teams.
Yeah, it feels like Klynx is kind of over-rotating and over-ganking, but they're doing this because they feel like they can transition Naga into the main character. Klynx is going to go into like the Medallion, maybe even upgrades it to a Solar Crest. We'll have to wait and see, but just like a Medallion, Deso, tons of minus armor. This is not going to be a carry Klynx in any conventional sense. Similarly, the Juggernaut, Drums build, more utility-based. I think the role of the Juggernaut and the Klynx at this point is just creating space for Naga. It's not the KP Naga. Apparently, it's going to be the Febi Naga this time.
Well, it's going to be the Arteezy anti-mage in danger if he doesn't blink out. He does. They still have the Snowball not quite in range, and he's got a max blink now. We'll be able to retreat.
Still a bit of... Has he got the battle fury? Still one item away. Still needs 1,200 gold, so...
Yeah, he did stop back for that single ring of regen, which very slightly slows it down, but that's only a couple creeps. Well, looks like KP does want the medallion. We've seen the Deso rush from... Oh, the Nuts. That's not where you want to be. Deep behind enemy lines, Arteezy says... Just stop. Just stop coming here.
Get some ward down, but yeah, no.
I'm tired of this crap.
And a Radiant Observer Ward. Oh, Zai was looking for a hookshot here. He just ignored the Obs Ward as he wanted to go in for the kill.
That's confident. I know you see me. I'm just that good. I'm going to hit you anyway.
Dire Observer plus Sentry. This is the ideal place to have that Obs Sentry duo as Klynx is constantly roaming towards your jungle, trying to take big creeps and then go for ganks.
And they did see him.
Yep.
The pings are coming out. But Juggernaut here finds Kuro. They don't want to commit an Omni Slash for this, so they're just going to go in with the Blade Fury, but he's going to go Scepter and actually cause him to take additional damage. Now the Omni hits on the two supports, kills out Puppy. It's an assassination in the mid lane. He will pay with his life, but he shreds him. And then Tusk comes in. Oh, hey, guys. Here's a fight. Not one I want to be involved in. Can I get out of here? Nope. Oh, please. Mercy.
And they lost the Klynx as well. That's a turnaround going Secret's way. 3-for-2 trade in their advantage. They kill off the two roaming kind of cores of MVP, and this is just space for Anti-Mage in general. So overall, really good for them. They're still not pressuring the Naga, but as an initially support Naga, this Febi... Well, he's actually now being pressured. Clockwork coming into
court. He has a Psalm in 5. He also has the Illusions to tank battery, so Febi should be able to get out of here as long as he doesn't get cogged. Waits too long for the Song, then the cooldown comes, and now he's done for.
I don't think you can Song against Battery Assault. I'm not...
Well, it wasn't hitting him constantly, though, there. He had a couple of seconds where he could have popped it.
Yeah, but when it was before it was on cooldown at that time though.
I think he had like a second, but he felt like he'd get cogged anyway.
Yeah. He had to.
And then he wouldn't have been able to TP.
He had to try like get back to the creep wave so the creeps tank some of the battery assault. But yeah, it was gonna be tricky.
He will go down. That's gonna delay any relic progression a lot. That was up to like 1600, starting to get close to that 2K mark. Now back down to 1200.
He picks up a cloak, so. Maybe it's just like, this isn't working, guys. I'm going Glimmer Cape. Forget the Radiance. The dream is dead.
Blink in. Arteezy does have his Battle Fury now. Febi looking for the net. Oh, they don't have an Omni, but the auto attacks alone might be enough to kill him off. QO. Oh, needs an extra crit. Arteezy, 20 HP. They're going to Song this. I don't know if it's going to matter. He's got a blink at the ready. Meanwhile, they kill the Clockwork off mid. One auto attack. One chop. He gets him. Off with your head. QO.
Got to use them drum charges, though. Like, if they'd used the drum initially with the ensnare, they get that kill before he gets the blink out. But yeah, that's a big kill to get. Anti-Mage just picked up Battle Fury. We're starting to gain some momentum. And also, clock going down elsewhere on the map. So yeah, nice couple of kills for MVP.
This Juggernaut is 1,500 gold up on a safe lane AM with 30 CS more, soloed mid against a Gyro, and just did work as KP jumps on mid. Oh, there, that's not strafe. Well, that's not going to be a CM kill. Does force her back a little bit. Secret looking for the split push, but seems like Secret really need to just slow the game down. This frantic pace that MVP have been bringing out is not really working for them. Starting to give up a lot of kills to Zai.
It's hard hero to play against as a Klynx, and he hasn't even gone for the Blade Mail, which is another really problematic item to deal with, but...
They have an Omni Slash here. These heroes TPing in. Must be careful. Looking for the call down. Rotation. Oh no, this could be terrible for Secret. Omni Slash and a crit. It's another death for Artesia. QO's not just done the hack a slash yet. Two for two thus far. He's hunting for a bit more. One side, but the battery assault fogging him and slowing him nicely. Blade Fury's at the ready. The jukes continue. QO decides he doesn't want to give up a potential kill streak. There's the TP out. No hook available, and he will make it away. Two for two. But considering that this gyro feels more utility than core, I think they're happy to get Arteezy there.
Absolutely. And like the Klinks was dead during that fight. They still come out pretty victorious in that clash. So it's a kind of engagement that MVP just want more of. Jug escaping. He picks up an SMY now. So maybe they, for a while, they were thinking, okay, let's try and run this Naga as a core, and they've changed their mind. It's hard to really tell without knowing what's going on in the MVP war room. But it really did seem they were giving Febby complete ownership of that safe lane for a good 10 minutes, but he just kept getting ganked. So I think they looked at QO and said, Juggernaut's actually completely dominating. Let's just not risk it. Get whatever items you can now, because if we play too passively, Secret are just going to get this anti-mage line and we lose. So I think they initially were planning on running him as a core going for the Radiance, but they just don't want to play a passive style when they've got this Juggernaut who's just steamrolling.
Well, it's really been all Zai. He's been the man of the hour for Secret. 5-3-6. With the Invis rune now popped, looking for a freebie. Finding a lot of solo kills here with the hook. It's a level 2 hook. There is a tower up bottom. QO presses in, and he has used the Blade Fury. No Omni even available. This might be an opening, but little does he know. KP's also here, and the rest of MVP in the neighborhood. He's going to scout them now as they rotate through to the bottom lane. Tower will drop. Healing Ward deployed. I could look to snipe it, keep tabs on it. Secret, do they want to try and hold this one? They do have the gyrocopter ult if necessary, but Zai just going for the stalling tactics. Arteezy will look to bring down this tier 1 top as the exchange. Both teams trading objectives here, but the healing ward's about to fall off, and QO tanking in the tower has to be careful about this. He's very, very low. Omni Slash now at the ready. They don't have a mech. March has gone 4 staff versus the clock. Secret just looking for
denied,
the trade.
I think. Yeah, they
just tanked too many tower shots.
Yeah, and they fumbled that a bit. Once the healing ward got sniped by Clock,
but they're going on mid. There's the song. What's the follow-up going to be? They've got a snowball at the ready. Arteezy, is he the target? Can they actually bring him down? Wall dropped. Novak, QO running. Can he get the Omni off here? Arteezy should be able to just blink out of it and survive regardless. Yeah. We'll make it out. Kuro, not so lucky. He'll be dropped by MVP, but that's a song committed. Arteezy alive.
Top. This is, for the most part, pretty good for Secret. They pressure mid, force rotations, they pressure top. They don't get the tier 2 tower,
but they're falling down. They want to go on this tower. Arteezy blinking in. Oh, does slow him. Last hit. Will they get it? Yes, they do. S4, the one to claim it. Now the healing ward and drum charges pop going in. Arteezy with the TP out. Nuts might be able to stop him. Snowball, they found him. He TP'd in vision. And MVP, find another.
It was the sigil that scouted him. That was just nuts. Getting that flying vision over on top and then found him with the snowball. That was really nice tusk play. And
Arteezy has been just so solid all event. I mean, to me, one of the most consistent carry players of the tournament, but a couple of unfortunate deaths here, and he'll get caught. Speaking of someone getting caught, KP, the jungle just isn't safe for him. Every time he comes in, Zai is waiting and stabs him with that hook.
It's tough. It's so much of Klinks' play is creating space, roaming around, trying to find those solo picks. You don't want a five-man with your team, but a disciplined team like Secret, sentries scattered around their jungle, and they've got a few times where they've had the Observer next to a sentry, so they see him coming in with vision as well. And
March is looking for Puppy Bottom. He's trying to play the economy game on his Crystal Maiden, but he's a bit lacking in the damage department. We'll let him go in the end. Meanwhile, mid. Looks like S4 able to take down the tier 1 tower. And
he's 2 towers in a row, gets a SMY as well as 1k gold on top of that, but the physical damage is a big problem for him. There's not really any easy way for him to itemize to be able to deal with this physical damage until he gets really big, like put a butterfly with a Scotty. At this point, he's just going to keep on farming. Satanic needs to probably get thrown in the mix. He needs a lot of items to be able to stand up to an Omni Slash, a Klinks who's hitting him with a Medallion, the Tusk Walrus Punch.
Now, Puppy is really farming it up here, up to 6,400 net worth, and he's behind only the Klinks on the side of MVP. Everybody very close in the middle of the pack. It looks like Secret's crushing in farm, but the only hero who's really down right now is the Tusk of Nuts, who's kind of forced into that more heavy support role. MVP do move Febby up. He's potentially for a go here on Arteezy. Throwing out the illusions. He looks like he'll go 4 staff as well next. Lots of tools for Zai's clockwork. Speaking of which, gets the medallion and Secret may have their eyes on a Roshan here soon. Move into the Radiant jungle now. Easy, looking to apply some additional pressure. See, it's, I have Scotty in the works for QO, the 6.83 Juggernaut build. It's gonna be the way he goes. Dire's middle
tower is under okay. Radiant's bottom tower for now, still not committed to anything, and it looks like Secret, for the most part, just looking to play a farming game. They're scattered on the map. You talked about how farm Puppy is. Arteezy's off deep in the enemy jungle alone. We've had Gyrocopter just trying to solo pressure towers and getting the space to do so. So, across the board, Secret are actually out farming. The last kind of 3 to 5 minutes, it's been about a 3,000 gold swing going Secret's way, mostly just from two towers going their way, as well as a couple of key kills.
They're going for this. Five-man smoke.
Rocket Flare just about to hit. Oh, it flies over. It doesn't actually go to Roche.
Uh-oh. Dire team did not see this.
That's a free Roche.
And this is a very quick Roche. And they've got the medallion going to work. Naga Illusion slowing down the push.
Sigil may go over the ward, which could reveal it. No, Sigil stays on Roche. That's
all right.
That's
very
play.
Nice for MVP. The rocket comes in. Will Zai go for some heroics here? Roche about to fall. QO already grabbed it. Before he really even had a chance to talk it over with his team. Zai, pretty cautious player in general. Not going to make that risky dive. But Kuro may get caught here. They've got a song, committing it just for him, waiting for backup to arrive. KP on the way. Go for the ensnare. There is a Yule Scepter and a Ghost Scepter, so he can remove that ensnare if he needs to, as well as dodge the Omni Slash. They got to commit a lot to get this kill. Back will stop the TP. Snowball to follow it up. Kuro will die, but space created at least for Arteezy. Pushy in the top lane, and S4 going on the bottom.
Yeah. So, not the biggest casualty for Secret. Klink's getting closer to a defusal, though, which will help deal with these multiple Ghost Scepters on the Secret side. But
only one for now, but may pick up another here soon. Whose courier was that?
I think that was the Radiant. Was that a Orb of Venom? Yeah, so it will be a Scotty for Jug. I think that was his Orb, but yeah, it was his Scotty component.
Just the Orb of Venom. May even just buy another rather than wait for the courier respawn. We'll see when he can pick it up.
He's got the money for Scotty otherwise. Yeah, like you say, buy a new one, you can
chasing
get
on Febby, but he's got a Glimmer Cape here as well as a four-step, and he's just going to Glimmer. Heads to the north. Team is coming. Tusk is about to be here with the Snowball. They ensnare Arteezy. Do they really have the Chain Stun to bring him down? They're going to need that Omni Sledge for the damage output they can bring to the table. QO walking in onto Puppy. He has to commit the Omni just for Crystal Beta, but Zai also joins this at the exact moment. He takes off two more heads, and Arteezy says, you know, I think the jungle feels like a better place to go right now.
Yeah. S4 gets a third tower in the last 5 minutes, though. It's kills in exchange for farm, as well as just towers, map control objectives. So it's still, I feel, overall slightly Secret favored, everything that's happened the last 5 to 10 minutes. But MVP are the ones who have the momentum. So they can just go from this and just start five-manning with an Aegis. You can threaten the high ground. And I feel like forcing Secret to defend as five is a great play.
Oh, there's the big ultimate from Kuro. Snowball trying to jump on him. Can he finish him off? Nuts does kill him. Now uppercuts. S4 looks to run. QO thinking about going. If he had the Scotty, he could get a lot more done in this fight, but Nuts will be left to the Wolves and left to the Copter, who cleans him up. KP will run away, and now it's the time for the Dire Courier to end up dying in the midst of all this. It just falls directly in front of the fight. I think it delivered a Yasha for Arteezy, or not actually 100% sure. By the way, it does go down.
For that push to work, they really had to keep the Darkseer alive, and I think Secret knew that was the key playmaking here for MVP. They threw everything at him, the Laguna, make sure he gets brought down. He's the one who's carrying the full staff, has the big vacuum wall combo, and Juggernaut didn't have an Omni Slash as well, so they just got to ignore him, kite him around, especially when he's got a second life in the Aegis. So good target selection from Secret. They kind of push back, lose a tier 2 tower, but get a slightly favorited fight towards their favor.
Favorably.
It's early in the morning, LD. Haven't had my coffee.
Oh. He'll TP out. I have Scotty probably about done now if he wants to buy it. I'm almost wondering if he's thinking of something different because he's really got the gold for it now. Oh, they're using the song again. Don't tell me Zai hooks his way out of this one. He's done it many times. They really can't allow him to get away after using that song. There's the net, and
he's got no hook.
Oh, he does have hook. Okay, it's on cooldown. But four step already used as well. They're going to snowball their way forward, and Zai's dead.
Yep.
I'm just so used to seeing him escaping, I didn't even bother to check. This guy.
Yeah, Arteezy's still keeping lanes pressured really well, so it's difficult for MVP to do it. I feel like they need
It's so underwhelming the level of farm he has, though. I mean, at this point, Safelane AM, you look at every other game Arteezy's played this event, and he has completed Manta and the makings of the next
they
item.
They see him ensnare into straight.
Arteezy playing deep in the enemy woods. The fire arrows now coming into play. Searing arrows, not it's quite enough. The purge was there. March is going to run around. Oh, he vacuum walls the wrong location. The pings even came out, but it was a bit too late. Arteezy just lucky to survive this time.
Level 2 ensnare, he just leveled it up to level 3 after he used it. I feel like having a max ensnare is so important.
S4, alright, well, okay. He baits out the ultimate.
Like, to go back to level 4 ensnare against Anti-Mage is crucial. The other big problem was Kling 7 Death Packed up, which is sometimes just comes down to the timing, but the ensnare level is something which he has complete control of.
They see Arteezy. Naga Illusions coming in. KP could almost finish him off here. Three shot, but the hook. Zai was ready for this. He's going to counter initiate. And KP trapped within the cogs, tries to fight his way out. He kills the wrong cog. It's going to push him up on the high ground. Maybe it was the right one in the end. As Zai goes down to the low ground where he can't quite find KP, then he's forced after safety. It's a miraculous Houdini of an escape, but still the Tusk will fall.
Oh,
and then KP
dies
anyway. He charges into the Crystal Maiden and goes flat in the end with the Mana Void to follow this up. Maybe they can get a bit more done. They really could use the Omni Slice, but they're lacking it because QO dropped to top. S4 charging in. Also Arteezy looking for kills here. QO in danger. They're going to lose the Darkseer. It's 3 dead. Might be more. Glimmering QO. Song. And is there a TP?
No mana.
No.
He's going to force stuff away.
Arcane's in force. Maybe he can get out. Blake. Rocket. Think Febby's got it. Oh, QO. Lucky to live there.
Just getting outmaneuvered around that area there. The Kling's thinking out of kill. Whoa.
No! MVP! Self-destruction! That 2 times in a row, Akor is bailed out by spectacular support play, and 2 times in a row, they run in and get killed off anyway on their own.
It's been so much Zai this game. Zai has been the one to punish the Klinks time and time again. He's always just tipping the scales in Secret's favor with these early pickoffs.
Just to, on the puppy. There's the purge. He glimmers, tries to retreat. The cooldown was waiting for them. They've already lost one. The Klinks is down as soon as he respawns. Tusk maybe next, trapped on the side of the cogs. 2 collapse. MVP not bringing their A game to these team fights. They need it. The Omni Slash will come through. It only gets one hero. That actually doesn't even finish anybody off. And now he's forced back. Now the chase on S4. QO on the run. They have nothing left. They keep on piling in and dying time and again. Secret, in a matter of just 3 minutes, have gone from losing as far as net worth, or at least being close to even, to taking a free lane of Rex mid and looking for a whole lot more. And there's another courier down.
That was a 10k plus gold swing in like 60 seconds.
Might be more.
Gone in 60 seconds. That was the MVP lead dissipating.
And with that, their upper bracket chances are gone, I believe, as well. Call down now to come through. If they can't find a way back into this game, they're going to have the BO1s awaiting them.
And it gets rough at this point. We talked about when the Anti-Mage pick came out. It looked like a great Anti-Mage game. It still remains the case where they haven't got the best lockdown to deal with him. They've got a lot of physical damage, but once he gets Mantisal with the Battle Fury Vlad's up and you throw like a butterfly on there as well, this Klinks isn't farming. You're not looking at an MKB anytime soon for him. And that's a problem because Gyrocopter's also gone for a butterfly and you've got 2 heroes with evasion. You need MKB. You also want to get for some lockdown, and Klinks is sometimes a hero who goes for that hex, but with KP's current level of farm, he's currently less farm than both Secret supports. That's the other thing to remember, where he is struggling to fight into this item advantage that the CM and Lina have. They have Ghost Scepters, Glimmer Capes.
Oh, they are wrapping on S4, snowballing their way into this one. The Walrus Punch comes through. Healing Ward's in the middle of the fight. Arteezy makes short work of that. No Omni for 10 seconds. Will QO even get it off? They're going to song and reset. And TP out of here. Looks like.
Oh, no.
No, they want to fight. They think better of it. Sticking around, March goes in, the back, the wall deployed, focus on S4, the Omni Slash only really hitting Illusions, now bouncing under Arteezy, but he just blinks away. Snowball on in, keeping the fight going, uppercut, is it enough? A couple more auto attacks, they can't get it done, and he finds a Haste Rune. Ay, 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 MVP, not catching the breaks they need, he blinks up again to the high ground, he sprints, away he goes, Zai, trapped within the cogs, may pay with his own life, Puppy looking to support him here from the sidelines, KP engaging, the snowball going onto Puppy, but he's glimmered, they can't finish him off. Kill that Zai. Finally, they'll get the job done. But everybody's still surviving and healthy here for Secret as S4 rejoins the fight. KP, the last man standing once again. The courier died this time.
No.
Dire Curry actually died.
KP. He bought back just looking for the clinks. He gets the Centaur Sun. That's the Gyrocopter Centaur, I want to say. Zai unfortunately did not have a hook shot otherwise.
That was another courier death, by the way.
On the middle of the Dire side?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Dire Courier took its turn to feed. Everybody's having a crack at it.
Well, last hurrah for MVP Phoenix and double Hyperstone Anti-Mage. Archer, having a bit of fun, I think.
Let's just rax them before we find a way to screw up a fight, because everybody's finding ways to screw things up this game.
Yeah,
it is a good item just to take rax though. That is for sure.
We get like a relic. I don't know. What Hyperstone probably a bit more cost effective, but
I mean, if you really AC is probably the better item, but you got to build it. So
yeah.
Here we go. Onto the tier 4.
Should have gone to Midas LD. That'd be the Arteezy way. Get the double Midas and then
surely would
push with the double Midas attack speed.
This is the end of the game now. Secret build. And then they go onto the towers. Force staff offensively used to push Arteezy slightly out of position. But the cooldown comes through from S4. And these cooldowns have been a problem for MVP. Multiple times hitting 3-4 heroes. They work on the throw now. And with this throne dying, should it fall, MVP's chances and hopes and dreams of the upper bracket will too. But they're going for one last song, one last fight before it's all over. Throne starting to drop. S4 focused on objectives. The vacuum wall into a snowball. Great combination play. But Monoboy was waiting for this. Arteezy finds the kill. His two Hyperstones and his hero back to the well. The GGs come out. MVP, they really had a great shot at this one, Gods. But the execution, well, it got away from them there in the mid game.
Yeah, Secret had completely lost the early game. It was MVP just snowballing. But then come mid game time, Secret just were getting a lot more out of the map. Even though it was MVP still finding the pickoff, Secret were the ones finding fantastic trades. They're taking